it's just us and it's a dim light and it's something else. It's like a third element.
This is a shower.
It's a very Bible-driven record. Bible has always been like one of the most, it's like a never-ending well of inspirations. The tone of it, the flavor of that era, you know, it sounds very ancient and it sounds old and it's one of the the strongest influences that we've ever gained as artists. These walls have seen it and have heard it, right?
Yeah.
This is one of the most legendary spots. You know, when it comes to music business and recordings and John Peel's spirit, it's just floating around and you can literally feel it. And it's, I mean, What I've been told that this place, I mean, these studios haven't really changed much ever since. Mm. They look like very retro, so to say, and I like it for the fact, you know, it's not super modern, but yeah, it's pretty challenging, you know, just to get to the room. You got like only, I don't know, like a couple of takes.
Yeah.
You must nail it, and then like on the spot they're mixing it, so it's quite a challenge, especially for us being a perfectionist and stuff. It's, you know, you need to compromise between the studio vibe and the concert vibe. It's something else.
It was
fucking amazing, man. I listened to this guy for the last 20 years. One of the dreams come true, man.
The Polish black metal scene still exists. So thank you.
Yes! We'll be right back.
is like all the good things, like all the atmosphere from the Satanist, they're just embracing like who they are.
Yeah, I basically got into the Demon just before the Satanist came out, so it was a really good time for me to get into them. And at the time I was at a really, really low point in my life, but every time I listen to the Demon, I just feel like the energy and this extreme power, and I don't know where it comes from.
You've still got that integrity, you've still got that power, but the music is continuing to evolve. And the thing that Behemoth do that other people don't, they have integrity in their music, and they make it work because they care about their music, whereas other people just try new things and try and be different. But you can get that vibe from Behemoth, that they actually believe in what they're doing, and you know they think, oh, we love bands like this, and they draw upon their influences.
Such beautiful lyrics throughout the whole album, like it's shocking how amazing they are writing music.
That's,
and I'm so glad they do.
Yeah, well, keep at it.
Yeah.
It's a great release because it's a big day for us. It's the 11th Behemoth album out there tonight. It's a release day, so thank you so much for being part of that. And we've been around since 91, 11th records. It takes a lot to to stay creative, to stay fresh. It's so hard, you know, when you're so, like, so many years into the process to reinvent yourself and just come up with something that you yourself will be surprised with. It takes everything. It's super difficult. And I truly hope that with music in the first place, and then all the aesthetics around the record, I Loved You at Your Darkest, we are reinventing ourselves while still being faithful to our roots, with not just cutting off that connection with our tradition, with the ancient, shut up, with the with the ancient heavy metal sound that we are huge admirers and worshippers, so to say. So this is Thou Art Darkest Exhibit. It contains the whole album, like all the booklet photography. Let's have some, you know, good time. Thank you so much once again. We're Behemoth, we are Silvia Makris, we are Melanie Guidos, and thank you so much. It's a pleasure to have you here. Enjoy it.